I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins, and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, 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 yeah. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, down, down.
What is up, guys? Dashing here for edition number 3 of Octane. And as always, we are jumping right into the action this evening. Troy Colt making his way to the ring. Quite a banger. We have to get things started here on Octane number 3 as Troy Colt going to be going one-on-one with Adam Valentine. A potential show stealer straight out the gate, but what a show overall we have in store, my friends. Of course, the Women's World Championship Tournament going to continue here tonight. Our last two first round matches as Jade Divine will battle Ashley Riot and Kyo will take on Mina. We saw a couple of days ago on Shockwave, both Ashley Rain and Gianna Di Natale advance to the semifinals. Who will join them? Take one step closer, go into Point Break, fight for the vacant Women's World Championship. And while it was Troy Cole and Adam Valentine who were both hoping they would be going to Point Break to challenge for the Global Championship, a part of that six-pack challenge last episode of Octane, which was eventually won by Kwame Bullitt. And now it is confirmed it's going down for real in the Great White North. Kwame Bullitt will challenge Blake Virtue for the CMV Global Championship. Kwame Bullitt going to have that home country advantage, but will it be enough? Later on tonight in our main event, we will see Kwame Bullitt's cousin and bodyguard Ruga going one-on-one with Blake Virtue. But both Colt and Valentine here hoping to get back to their winning ways. Perhaps be next in line for a shot at the CMB Global Championship. Whomever leaves Point Break with the title. First time matchup here between Troy Colt and Adam Valentine. Both superstars hungry. Want to get their hands on that CMV Global Championship. They had their shot last week, but came up short. But the grind never ends, as we know here in CMV. And Colt with a hot start here against Adam Valentine. Of course, he has his protege, Chloe Marks, in his corner. She had that great match just last night on Aftershock against the returning Kikiko. Troy Colt certainly wasting no time going up to the top rope. Beautiful moonsault. Things getting underway. Rough and rugged here for Adam Valentine. Now Troy Colt going to show off again with that side headlock headstand. And now an Anaconda Vice. My goodness, Troy Colt going hard in the paint, as they say, but gets a couple of knees to the back of the head. Valentine able to break himself free there. Also to come here tonight, guys, Crimson X going to be going one-on-one with Cousin Chase. Also going to have some tag team action in the women's division as the Pure take on the team of Violet Evans and Jane Stone. Kick to the chest, caught by Colt, turned into a Dragon Screw. Point break right around the corner, my friends. Live from Canada. Great card already taking shape. Knee right across the face of Adam Valentine, courtesy of Troy Colt. Oh, another Dragon Screw. Adam Valentine going to show him how it's done here. Woohoo! Troy Colt just got the taste knocked out of his mouth, but straight back up and into the fight. Perhaps a bit too quick for Valentine to keep up with here. Kick to the midsection, misses that kick to the chest, though. And Valentine looking for a TKO, countered by Colt into a reverse DDT. These two, no feeling out process, man. Hooks the leg to Troy Colt, only to get a one count, though. Oh, vintage Troy Colt, my friends, with that bicycle big boot. Right to the jaw of Adam Valentine, but the self-proclaimed GOAT of CMV not staying down for very long. Gets knocked down to the outside, almost landed right on top of Chloe there. Quick thinking there by Adam Valentine. Oh, geez, Valentine trying to throw Troy Colt right into Chloe Marks. Wisely, she's going to get out of the way. These two are just going at it, man, nonstop since that bell rang. Back and forth, back and forth. No rest for the wicked. Already up to a count of six as well. Head official of the action here on Octane Johnson. Not playing around. Eight now as Valentine throws Troy Colt down onto the ground, rolls back into the ring. Gonna do a little bit of fanfare as Troy Colt returns to the fight. Spinning Valentine around the 330 slam. Will that be enough? One, two, no, and that's why you do not run your mouth when you're against Troy Colt, because just like that, man, he almost had Adam Valentine dead to rights. Fans loving what they're seeing so far, chanting fight forever. So it's been a wild matchup. Jeez, Valentine with a trio of headbutts. First drop kick to the shoulder, tries for the stomp. Gets out of the way, just Colt goes for an enziguri hook to the jaw instead, gonna spin him around, back suplex. Nasty landing there for Troy Colt, able to fire off a kick to the top of the head though, ringing Valentine's bell. Collar and elbow tie, gonna go for the TKO again. No. Oh, discus ya puncha. Off that fireman's carry. Now Valentine wanting to slow things down. How fast paced this match has been so far. Valentine realized, oh man, I gotta get this guy grounded. Can't keep up with him. Kick to the side of the head, and Troy Colt gonna go right back to work on the head and neck of Valentine with this side headlock. Off the ropes he goes. Nice knee drop right to the eye of Adam Valentine, it looked like. Another knee drop. That one's gonna miss, though. Valentine moving out of the way with a millisecond to spare. And wait a minute! Valentine, just like that, pedigree! One, two, oh my lord, what a match. You knew this was gonna be hot though. Between these two and Valentine has no plans of stopping anytime soon. The vintage cutter. Troy Colt gonna take it on the chin like the PIMP that he is. Quickly up to the top rope. Valentine closing in on him, though. Keeps him at bay. His call. Oh, cannonball senton. Busting Valentine open, guys. And Troy Colt has won with this submission move before. Last chancery cinched in here. Middle of the ring. Nowhere for Valentine to go. Will he tap here tonight to kick off Octane number three? No. Troy Colt releasing the hold. Valentine bloodied. Troy Colt evidently wants that arm. Hang on a second! Colt's gonna lock it in again! Last chance, he locked in again! And Valentine, guys, barely able to survive before. Can he survive again? He's fighting with all he has left. I don't think he's gonna tap. Troy Colt's gotta be getting miffed here. What's he gotta do? Another knee drop targeting that cut. Wait a second. Troy Colt poised to hit a second 330 slam. No, countered by Valentine. The GOAT of CMV with eyes in the back of his head. Escapes the clutches of Colt, and here we go. Valentine sees his opening, takes his shot, a second pedigree. One, two, what the hell? Yeah, Valentine's reaction here, I'd say pretty apropos. Troy Colt just kicked out of a second pedigree, and the fans were chanting one more time. It seems like Adam Valentine is gonna give them what they want. But wait a minute, Troy Colt counters the pedigree. And a second 330 slam! Hooks the leg! One, two, three! Troy Colt! That lived up to the hype and then some. What a way to get things started here tonight, my friends. Wow. Troy Colt kicking out of two. Two pedigrees. You can see Colt not leaving this match without some wounds of his own, but this is a step in the right direction for Troy Colt. And coming up next, lads and gents, it is our first round matchup of the evening in the Women's World Championship Tournament as Jay Devine gets set to go one-on-one with Ashley Riott. Later on tonight, it will be Keio and Mina in the final first round matchup. We already know on the next episode of Shockwave, we will see Ashley Rain battle Gianna Di Natale in the first semifinal matchup. Now, who will it be competing in the other semifinal matchup? Who is going to Point Break? Who will be crowned the new Women's World Champion? Will it be a fresh-faced rookie leading this era? Or will it be a veteran leading that charge, standing at the top of the mountain, ushering in the next chapter here in CMV? This has the potential to be a hell of a matchup, no doubt about that, and has been a bit of beef over the last couple of weeks between the pillars of the women's division, Jay Devine and Amber Briggs, and Ashley Riott. Of course, twice now, the pillars have gotten the better of Riott. Amber Briggs beating Riott one-on-one. And last episode of Octane, we had the pillars defeating the team of Ashley Riott and RVW in tag team action. This is where it matters most, though. Women's World Championship Tournament. Jay Devine, of course, Hall of Famer, former Vixens champion, former Women's World Champion. Never got her rematch towards the end of last season after Jade Dynamite took the title from her. And Ashley Riott, of course, still a rookie in many ways. She's only been here in CMV, debuting shortly after Ascendance 9. Only been around maybe, say, 5-6 months or so, maybe even less than that. But in that amount of time, Ashley Riott quickly becoming a fan favorite and proving exactly why she deserves to be here in the women's division, the greatest women's division in wrestling today, in my humble opinion. They're competing multiple times already for the Women's World Championship, always coming up short, though. Will this finally be Riott's opportunity to break the glass ceiling, if you will? Or will Jade Divine once again make her way to the top of the mountain? Jay Devine going to have the support of Amber Briggs here at ringside tonight. I'm sure Ashley Riott will have RBW in her corner. Let's not forget, later on tonight, Keio and Mina one-on-one in our final first-round matchup. Just like we needed a new undisputable heavyweight champion, guys, here in the new season. The women's division needs a leader as well. Can't think of a much better one and the cheeky Japanese girl, Jade Divine. Hall of Famer. Ashley Riott, though, prepared to do what she must. Get her hands on that Women's World Championship that has managed to elude her thus far here in her CMV career. Not much, just the first matchup, which was a certified banger between Troy Colt and Adam Valentine. We still have much to look forward to here tonight. Ashley Riott's got herself a new look. Go along perhaps with a whole new outlook on her career here in CMV. Riott ended last season with a bang, winning that fatal four-way at CyberSlam. Many considered her to be number one contender coming into the new season here. But nothing is handed to anyone here in CMV. You gotta earn it. Riott more than happy to do so. Power number type immediately, Jade Divine. Going for a schoolboy, but not going for the win. Instead, kicking Riott right upside the head. Now targets the arm as we get set for some more incredible action here tonight on Octane number 3. Of course, Crimson X will be going one-on-one with Cousin Chase a little bit later on tonight. Not to mention our main event, the hulking Ruga makes his in-ring debut. The cousin, of course, and bodyguard of number one contender Kwame Bullitt. Ruga hoping to wear down CMV Global Champion Blake Virtue here tonight ahead of Point Break, live from the Great White North. Forearm smash going to take Divine down here in the corner. Tries for a stomp. Looks like Divine's able to catch it. Oh, but Riott's going to get through anyway. Elbow drop to the lower back of Jade Divine. There's a reason that Jade Divine and Amber Briggs call themselves the pillars of the women's division. They've been here since the start. They've been to the top of the mountain many times. They know what it takes. They want to keep these rookies in line. Now, it's been a real battle so far. In the first few weeks of this new season, between the rookies, all these new faces, and then the steadfast vets, not willing to budge, not willing to stand aside. And so far, the rookies, man, have been running roughshod. Will that continue here tonight? Dragon Skidoo by Riott. Very smart thinking. Ashley obviously coming into this match with a game plan. Take out the legs of Jade Divine. Can't use that incredible athleticism of hers. Can't go for the Divine Arrow. Power number type. Irish Rip going to send Riott into the corner. Cautious approach by the Hall of Famer. Turns her around. Gonna put her up top. Jay Devine already looking for the spider suplex. Yes, she is. Well, Devine did not come to play around here tonight, lads and gents. We know what comes. Oh, well, she usually follows that up with the Devine arrow. Instead, we get a corkscrew arm drag. Now going up to the top rope. And here it comes. Devine arrow. Will it be? One, two. Wow. And how about that? Only a few minutes into this match, and Jay Devine just very, very nearly had Ashley Riott done for. And Riott now kicking it into overdrive. Saying, you want to play like that? Let's play that lift and reverse DDT. High kick, misses the first one, but makes up for it. See Riott rushing into the pin, hooks the leg. One, two. Ashley Riott. So close there to advancing to the semifinals of this Women's World Championship tournament. And as Riott circles Jay Devine, you have to imagine she's looking to hit that stomp. The Riott Act, she calls it. And here it comes, just as I was saying so. Countered by Devine, though, into a cutter. Good Lord in heaven. Never tire of that reversal. Super quick thinking from the cheeky Japanese girl, saving herself for perhaps being put down for the uno, dos, tres. Punch right between the eyes. Devine gonna grab Riott, launch her into the corner with a monkey flip. Jay Devine gonna take her shot, but Riott popping up to her feet, not giving Devine the opportunity here. Devine's gonna go for it, says fuck it. Whisper in the Wind does not connect fully, but certainly got a lot of it. And now Devine has Ashley Riott in the danger zone. Wait a minute, the Devine arrow does not connect. It looks like she kneed Riott in the gut. Goes for the Whisper in the Wind again. This time Riott able to prepare for it, steps out of the way. And wait, Riott with the Riott Act. She had her shot and she took it. One, two, no. Unbelievable, Ashley Riott. So close. And yet so far away. These Octane fans on their feet. Loving what they're seeing thus far. And of course, both of these women giving it their all because so much is on the line here. Another corkscrew arm drag. This is quite a distance. Devine arrow! Numero dos! One, two, three! Jane Devine advances to the semifinals. That was as fast-paced as they come. Goddamn, from bell to bell. Absolutely incredible, but it is Jay Devine who's gonna head to the semifinals, and Ashley Riott, who once again has to go back to the drawing board. There was no time to waste here tonight for these two, evidently. And now we've got ourselves some tag team action coming up next, my fine feathered friends, as it will be the CMB International Champion Jay Young and Bloody Justice, a unique tandem, no doubt about that, taking on the pairing of Jason Spade and the CMB Anarchy Champion Fidel De La Rosa in two matches. have been confirmed for Point Break, as we will not only see Jason Spade challenging Jae Young for the CMV International Championship in a Submissions Count Anywhere match, but also Bloody Justice will get his shot at the CMV Anarchy Championship, a rematch from last episode of Octane, he versus Fidel De La Rosa. Of course, anything goes for that CMV Anarchy Championship, and Bloody Justice pinning, defeating Fidel De La Rosa last week here on Octane, clean as a whistle, 1-2-3. Will this be BJ's chance to finally, believe it or not, capture his very first singles title here in CMV? Jae Young's been talking a lot of shit, of course, over the last couple of weeks about Jason Spade hiding behind Madison Wright, but Spade saying Madison Wright won't be showing up to Point Break. It'll just be them two for the International Championship and Submissions Count Anywhere. That means there are no pinfalls, no countouts, no disqualifications either. Can only win by submission, but submission can happen in the ring, outside the ring, out in the street, down the block. Certainly going to be a hell of a matchup to see, and momentum certainly at stake here in this tag team matchup. You know, Fidel De La Rosa and Jason Spade, an interesting team as well, considering the fact it was Fidel De La Rosa who captured the CMV Anarchy Championship from Jason Spade at the end of last season, part of that hardcore battle royal at CyberSlam. So I'm sure these two aren't exactly on good terms, but going to try to work together here against their respective enemies. We know that Jae Young, not in the best mood, not that he typically is anyhow, but Jason Spade has continually gotten the better of him over these last couple of weeks. Of course, that revamped Spade tapped out Jae Young. And that really got under Young's skin, because Young considers himself one of the greatest technical wrestlers today here in CMV, and attempted to attack Jason Spade after his matchup with Bloody Justice on the debut edition of Octane, but Jason Spade saw the attack coming, sent Jae Young running for the hills. And of course, it was during that brawl that Madison Wright got involved, prompting Jae Young to start talking all this shit, spreading all these rumors about Jason Spade hiding behind our general manager of Octane. But Jason Spade saying, I don't need Madison Wright to beat your ass. You won't have her as an excuse come Point Break in that Submissions Count Anywhere match. Both Jae Young and Jason Spade a part of that six-pack challenge last episode of Octane. Able to get their hands on each other in that matchup as well. The CM Universe waiting with bated breath. Will this finally be The time for Bloody Justice to shine, my friends. Will he finally capture his first singles title at Point Break when he gets Fidel De La Rosa one-on-one for the CMV Anarchy Championship? He did it last week. He beat Fidel De La Rosa clean. Non-title matchup. But of course, I'm sure Fidel is going to bring everything and then some with the championship on the line. Could be a wonderful night for the Justice family at Point Break. We know as well, Joy Justice, BJ's sister, will be taking on Ellie Quinn in a street fight. Bloody Justice saying before this season began, he will lead his family to success here in the new era of CMV. Will that begin at Point Break? Fidel, again, capturing that CMV Anarchy Championship at the end of last season. It's part of the Hardcore Battle Royal at CyberSlam. Taking the title from his tag team partner here tonight, Jason Spade. His first defense at Point Break. Fidel De La Rosa, more often than not, though, since debuting here in CMV not that long ago, has had championship gold around his waist, whether it be the Internet Championship, the Unified World Tag Team titles, or the Anarchy Championship. No, Bloody Justice never held any singles championship. The former two-time Fusion Tag Team Champion and a former Unified World Tag Team Champion, but never has he held a singles title. Something this man has accomplished many times. Of course, a two-time undisputed World Heavyweight Champion, a former Zero-G Champion, a former Anarchy Champion. But now Jason Spade has his sights set on becoming international champion. And it's not just Jay Young that's throwing all this abuse at Jason Spade since the new season began. These rumors spreading like wildfire. So many people talking that trash about Jason Spade only being in the position he's in because of Madison Wright hiding behind our GM, along with many other things that we can't repeat here on a Christian Family show. But Spade has argued back against his critics, saying, "I am where I am because I'm Jason Spade. And nobody's going to have an excuse. Most of all, Jay Young at Point Break when I leave as international champion." But momentum is on the line. Things going to kick off here in this tag team matchup between Jay Young and Fidel De La Rosa, champion versus champion. Quick to use that top turnbuckle as a weapon. Still to come here tonight, guys. The final first round matchup of the Women's World Championship Tournament going to take place. Kyo battling Mina. Also going to see some tag team action in the Women's Division a little bit later on as the Pure will battle Violet Evans and Jane Stone. And in our main event, Ruga debuts, taking on Blake Virtue. What the hell is Jay Young setting up for here? Oh my god, dropkick right to the chest of Fidel as he was tied up in the ropes. Carnival tie-up now, Fidel. Getting walked over to the corner, not where he wants to be, able to escape. Ah! couple of knees to the back. Now going to drop Jae Young into a reverse DDT. Kick to the side of the head. And again, rolls out of the way, though. That's the prodigy of Dave Turner, Hall of Famer. Can't ask for a better teacher than that. That's why I think Jae Young is so peeved about this whole situation with Jason Spade. The fact that Jason Spade forced him to tap out at Revamp. Jae Young considers himself to be the very best technical wrestler here in CMB today, maybe of all time. Oh, what a knee! Into an inverted Frankensteiner. Holy shit, Jae Young says, let me get the fuck out of here real quick. But if he does, it's also going to stop him from crawling away. Tag made to Jason Spade. These two able to work together so far. Double back body drop. Jae Young got some serious height on that one. Spade going right up to the top rope. Looks like Bloody Justice going to intervene. Spade jumping off, though, before he can. Hammer fist right to the top of the head. Hot tag made to Bloody Justice. And here we go, a rematch from a couple of weeks ago. Jason Spade knocked off Bloody Justice mano a mano. It was after that that Jae Young attacked Spade. Madison Wright got involved. Allowed Jason Spade to get the upper hand. Who doesn't love Johnny Sampson? May he find happiness wherever he is today. Tag made to Jae Young. Wicked kick to the midsection. Forearm smash. Great combo by the international champion. Of course, Jae Young capturing that championship at CyberSlam. Triple threat matchup. His first singles title. Former NGW Tag Team Champion, former Unified World Tag Team Champion as well. Not thinking of very much right now after that old school pile driver from Jason Spade. Now makes the tag to Fidel. Swinging neck breaker. Jae Young trying not to stay grounded for very long. Gets busted open off those kicks to the face. And it looks like he's already bleeding pretty badly. Wow, what a discus clothesline. Very lazy pin, though. Only gets a two count. Would have been broken up by Bloody Justice anyway. Fidel pissed off going after BJ. BJ going to get back out onto the apron, though. That's Fidel. Not letting Jae Young get away. Could be going for that crossface of his. And Jae Young saying, I am not tapping out again. Beautiful Tiger Bomb. Wisely makes a tag to Bloody Justice. Great matchup between these two. Last episode of Octane pulls him up into a back suplex. One of the bigger wins for Bloody Justice in recent memory. Now he's got his shot, his opportunity. One-on-one against Fidel De La Rosa. At Point Break for the CMV Anarchy Championship. Cheeky jab, forearm smash, and again, overhand rocking Fidel. And a sit-out choke bomb, or I guess a kneeling choke bomb. Uh-oh! And you see Fidel De La Rosa, guys, since last week has studied Bloody Justice, able to counter that spinning tombstone pile driver. Makes the tag to Jason Spade, who comes in swinging. Discus forearm smash caught by Bloody Justice. Throws him over his shoulder. Sternum first, and that top rope ain't gonna feel too good, my friends. Now we get a lifting reverse DDT. No counter! Wow, nicely done by Jason Spade. He's gonna go for another pile driver. Everybody gets a taste. Jason Spade don't discriminate as he goes up to the top rope. Could be looking for that double boot stomp of his, but Bloody Justice back to his feet, gonna charge Spade, throws him off the top rope rather unceremoniously, and the tag made to Jae Young as Jason Spade looks to make a hot tag to Fidel De La Rosa. Great trio of jabs there. God damn, mixing it up. Horde is Fidel. Look at this combo! Jae Young. Not even knowing what's hitting him. Bloody Justice coming over to try and help out his tag team partner as Fidel goes off the top rope. Beautiful Houston hangover, but he did not get all of it. Fidel De La Rosa, knowing that, Snapmare slides to the front. Kick right to the side of the head. Will that be enough? One, two. No, very, very close call there for the CMB Anarchy champion, but this match not over just yet. As Fidel continues the attack. Leg drop, Bulldog going old school, you might say. Now Fidel, maybe again looking for that cross face, but Jay Young able to counter with an elbow to the midsection. Goes for another Tiger Bomb. Bloody Justice brought back into the fight. Fidel hurting for certain right now. Bloody Justice wanting to finish him off. Pin him 2 weeks in a row. Can't ask for better momentum than that. Another inverted Frankensteiner. Good Lord Almighty. Let's see if Jason Spade can finish things off here. Right for that vintage knee of his. And now he's going to lock in the Color City Clutch. Color City Clutch is locked in here by the Outlaw. Ah, but Jay Young able to pretty easily break that up. Too close to the corner. Might have had the match won right there. Spade got to realize his surroundings, though. He was way too close to their corner there. Goes for a pin now. Kick out by Bloody Justice. It's Jason Spade looking for blood. Closed fists from side control. Hook to the jaw, gonna spin BJ around. Reverse DDT, Bloody Justice instantaneously. That's that veteran instinct. Makes the hot tag to Jay Young, who comes in with a big old gut kick. Now sending Spade out of the apron, trying to hang on for dear life. Drop kick, gonna knock the Outlaw down to the outside, though. Have a nice trip. See you next fall. Spade getting right back up. Absolute unit. Knife edge chop. Up against the ropes, Jason Spade. Fights back with an elbow to the jaw. Lifting, reverse, DDT, a crush. Spade's got something cooking. This is not good news for Jay Young. Tag made to Fidel De La Rosa. These two going to work together again. Another double back body drop. De La Rosa now going to be cheeky with the international champion. Who's the better champ here? Fidel pretty confident it is him as he continues to insult Jay Young. Bloody Justice still incapacitated at ringside, by the way. Just now getting back up, as you can see. Standing Spanish fly by the TV Nightmare. And the Regal Stretch, shades of one of the greatest technical wrestlers of all time, guys, and Fidel just tapped out. The Regal Stretch forcing Fidel De La Rosa to tap out just about instantaneously. Jay Young and Bloody Justice with a huge win here tonight. Wish we had a better angle on that Regal Stretch. Great teamwork by Fidel De La Rosa and Jason Spade throughout this match, but look at that Jay Young, man. This is one mean mofo. And Jay Young do that at Point Break, however, and leaves still international champion when it is submissions count anywhere against Jason Spade. And coming up next, some singles action, guys, as Crimson X prepares to go one-on-one with Cousin Chase. And Crimson X going to be joined by Shanaz Andoni, this blossoming alliance between Crimson X and Shanaz Andoni beginning a couple weeks ago when they went one-on-one. Crimson X victorious, but afterwards offering a handshake to Shanaz Andoni and saying, "Join me." Shanaz Andoni taking Crimson X up on this offer, the two of them teaming up together and picking up a win against, I believe, it was Hugo Steele and Don Gianfranco. But Crimson X saying to Shanaz Andoni, "I don't want you to be a tag team champion again. You've done that time and time again in your CMV career. We all know you're a phenomenal tag team competitor. I want to bring you to new heights. I want to make you a world champion." And so Shanaz Andoni saying, "Let me study you then." Of course, I can't do a very good Shanaz Andoni impression. I wouldn't do it justice. But Shanaz here tonight to take notes, to watch closely how Crimson X conducts himself. When you say oddball pairings, I don't think you could find two more different individuals than Crimson X and Shanaz Andoni. And then you add Cousin Chase to the mix, and you've got yourself a party. Cousin Chase, who debuted last week here in CMV with a win against the Ozekai on Ignition. A pretty incredible way to debut. Shaking my goddamn head. That was Salim Ismail. Crimson X been very successful so far this season. Of course, the highest paid competitor in CMV today, as we found out during the draft. What does Crimson X see in Shanaz Andoni, though? Not to take anything away from Shanaz Andoni, of course. He is a phenomenal competitor. Something about Shanaz has just gotten under the skin of Crimson X. Are his intentions pure? Does he truly want to bring Shanaz Andoni to new heights here in CMV? Or is he just looking for a new lackey? Shanaz Andoni is the trusting type. He seems to be all in with Crimson X. Crimson X obviously doing something right. Shanaz Andoni chasing that bag. Cousin Chase making an impact straight out the gate last week on Ignition with his win against the Ozekai. And this is just a fun-loving fella. But once he gets in that ring, once that bell rings, it's a whole different ball game, as we saw last week during his debut. So Crimson X would be wise not to underestimate Cousin Chase. Will Crimson X even be able to lock in that dungeon lock of his on someone with the girth of Cousin Chase? I guess we'll find out, or maybe not. Here we go, Crimson X taking on Cousin Chase. Shanaz Andoni at ringside, taking notes, studying the movements of Crimson X, how he conducts himself, how he goes after an opponent, just like this. You see Crimson X already starting to wear down Cousin Chase. or the Dungeon Lock. Still to come here tonight, my friends, our final first round matchup in the Women's World Championship Tournament as Kia will battle Mina. Which of them will face Jade Divine on the next edition of Shockwave? Ooh! Chase with a beautiful butterfly. Sort of powerbomb. Full mount, Crimson X. Always rough. Nothing pretty about his offense. It is all sinister. But all with purpose. He's continuously stomping on that bicep. Let's remember, the Dungeon Lock not only targets the legs, the knees, but also the arm. Specifically, the right arm. And there we go. Pleasant Chase starting to use his power. Dragon Screw by Crimson X as he sees Shinhas watching so intently at ringside. He wants to know everything. He wants to be a world champion. Will Crimson X take him there, though? Go behind German suplex. How about the power of Crimson X? Not that Crimson X is a small guy or anything, but Cousin Chase, over 300 pounds. Reminds me of someone else. I just don't know who, though. I'm trying to put my finger on it. A couple of jabs from Crimson X. Now going to walk Chase over to the corner. My man needs a back shaving real quick. Speaking of his back, just getting whacked off the turnbuckles there. Back into the full mount. Jawbreaker gives Cousin Chase some room to breathe. Hook to the jaw, though, spins him around. Oh, and there's the vintage seatbelt suplex, guys, of Crimson X. Hooks the leg. One, two. Not enough, though, to keep down Cousin Chase. The Crimson X, he is not the kind to beat around the bush, my friends. No time waster shooting for the Dungeon Lock, but Cousin Chase able to see it coming. How about that? Cousin Chase obviously did his homework, brother. Oh, my Lord in heaven. Oh, 300 plus pounds right down across the chest of Crimson X. And now Cousin Chase is hungry. Trying to bite off a finger. Cousin Chase with that single underhook, knee to the gut. Cousin Chase for the dub here tonight. Man, 2.5 close, but no cigar. And these fans chanting, "We are not worthy." Is anyone truly worthy of Cousin Chase? Wow! What an overhead belly to belly. Crimson X just popping right back up, though. Like it ain't no thing. The Dungeon Lock didn't work. Get ourselves a Fujiwara armbar. Cousin Chase in a world to hurt right now, but for a big guy, man, he's got a little bit of athleticism. Able to escape that. A couple of knees to the midsection, gonna knock Crimson X down. Oh, another single underhook knee to the gut from Cousin Chase into the pin once more. Uno, dos. Chase! Cousin Chase! Handing Crimson X his first loss here in the new season. And I wonder what kind of notes Shinhas Andoni got from that performance. Cousin Chase might be the nicest guy in the world when he's in that locker room. But like I said, and look at that, he even has Sugar and Ralph as fans. Cousin Chase has already won in life. Once that bell rings, Cousin Chase means business. Great win here tonight against Crimson X. Shinhas Andoni.
All right, sorry about that. Lawnmower guy coming to my door. It's all right, Ralph. It's all right. Just too excited in this house for Cousin Chase, you know. It's how it is around the world, though. All right. Let's continue with the action here tonight on Octane. Number 3, my friends, is coming up next is our final first round matchup in the Women's World Championship Tournament. We already have our first semifinal matchup set for the next episode of Shockwave. It will be Ashley Rain battling Gianna Di Natale. And we saw earlier tonight Jade Divine defeat Ashley Riot to advance to the second semifinal matchup. Who will she be meeting in that match? Will it be Kyo or will it be Mina? As at Point Break, we will crown a new Women's World Champion. Could potentially be Kyo, who has, in a matter of weeks, man, gotten the CM Universe behind her. Perhaps more so than any other new face in the women's division here. Did suffer her first loss at DEF CON 3 in that triple threat matchup, pinned by Ellie Quinn. Now Kia is especially going to try to be bouncing back here tonight. But she's got her work cut out for her. I'm sure she knows that. However, this is the same gal that pinned Amber Reed one-on-one, clean as a whistle, in her first singles match. We saw Mina make her season debut last week with a win against Anna Nixon, the former women's hardcore champion, looking to move on to bigger and better things here tonight. The Women's World Championship on her mind. Again, the winner of this matchup will face Jade Divine on the next episode of Shockwave. And that semifinal matchup, will it indeed be one of these rookies that leads the women's division into this brand new era, or will it be a veteran who has been to the top of the mountain before? Also a big Mina fan, evidently, is Ralph. Can't blame him there either. So here we go. Kyo, Mina, one-on-one. Our final first-round matchup. Dodges that high kick. Does Kyo straight out the gate and respond with a cravat suplex into the corner. Still to come here tonight, guys. Got ourselves some tag team action in the women's division. Kyo applying a camel clutch, looking to break Mina's back perhaps and make Hambel, but Mina's already a pretty humble gal, able to escape there, pulling at the ankles of Kyo. But it will be the Pure taking on Violet Evans and Jane Stone a little bit later on in our main event. Ruga gonna make his debut as he goes toe-to-toe with the CMV Global Champion Blake Virtue, ahead of Virtue's defense of the Global Championship against Ruga's cousin Kwame Bullet at Point Break. Kwame Bullet already a lot of momentum on his side, and of course a huge advantage at Point Break as he will be competing in front of his friends, his family, his home country of Canada. Blake Virtue has his work cut out for him. Virtue hoping to change things here tonight after suffering a couple of losses so far this season. Not a good look for the champ. Elbow across the side of the face there by Kyo. Hook to the jaw. Into a collar and elbow tie up. Breaks free though, does the former women's hardcore champion, with some elbows to the gut and a knee to the gut as well. Around and around and around we go with the Whirly Bird head scissors. And then a moonsault. She went off the bottom rope. Oh, I don't know if I've ever seen that before. Came off the bottom rope for that springboard moonsault. That was pretty cool. Snap vertical suplex by Kyo. Keeping it simple here early on against Mina. But I'm sure Kyo going to be looking to kick it up searching for that Tanahashi clothesline of hers. Or what the hell is she going for here? Lining up her shot. Basement drop kick. Double boots right to the dome of Mina. One, two. Only a two count though for Kyo. But a second away from advancing to the semifinals. Kyo knows it too. Mina's hurting. Tanahashi clothesline. Hooks the leg. One, two. So close she could taste it right there, but our head official Johnson saying, not so lucky. Man, and these fans are loving the action here tonight at Octane. Another Fight Forever chance. We've had great matches here tonight so far. Helicopter spin, Kyo. Adding some insult to injury with a slap to the back of the head. Going back into the camel clutch now. Tried this at the start of the match. Maybe it'll pay off this time though. Going to break her back. Make her humble. Forced to let go though. Mina not going to be quitting here tonight. Tries for a knee drop. Rolls out of the way. Have ourselves another whirly bird head scissors. Making Kyo nice and dizzy. Standing shooting star press. Never ceases to amaze. Requires some incredible athleticism. Spins her around. Ooh! Okay. Okay. Short arm fireman's carry. Mina now just starting to pop off. Goes off the ropes into the whirly bird head scissors. Love it. And now Mina, what is she setting up for here? That stance she was using there was quite interesting, man. I have to assume it's probably going for that headlock driver. Kyo did her homework though, and it paid off. Another snap vertical suplex. Biding her time. Kyo not rushing anything here. Not going to make a rookie mistake. Not with so much on the line. Tanahashi clothesline! A second time. One. Oh, no. And Kyo devastated at the fact that Mina getting that rope break. Is, oh, wait a minute. Third Tanahashi clothesline. Kyo saying, hey, you want to play that game? One, two, three. Kyo advances to the semifinals. An emphatic victory over Mina there. Tanahashi clothesline followed up by a Tanahashi clothesline. Great matchup here between these two and Mina. Not going to let there be any hard feelings. Kyo offers the handshake, and finally we see a rookie and a vet not trying to kill each other for once. And ladies and gentlemen, I have just received word. We're trying to get cameras on the scene for you as quickly as humanly possible because it appears as though the Ted has hunted down Josh Wolf backstage, has found Josh Wolf isolated from the rest of Click. And as we all know, what happened last week here on Octane, Click throwing Tracy James headfirst into a vending machine. Tracy James not here tonight. And, oh. What the hell? The Ted throwing Josh Wolf
down the ramp. They just, well, we were trying to get cameras backstage to find out what the hell was going on, but it looks like Ted is going to make our job easy. He just threw Josh Wolf down the ramp. He wants everyone to see this beaten. We know that a huge war is set to take place at Point Break. It will be Bob Luger, Xander Slade, and Josh Wolf versus Timotheus and the team in an anything goes tornado tag team matchup. But Tracy James is not here tonight because of Click sending him headfirst into that vending machine last week. And the Ted just looking for a bit of payback here for his tag team partner. But it might not end up going his way, my friends. Josh Wolf throwing him out of the hip. And again, this is not a match. I have to reiterate that. We were trying to get cameras backstage to find out what was going on, but the Ted instead brought Josh Wolf out here to the ring. Wants to beat his ass in front of the CMV Universe, it would seem. Oh, Josh Wolf with On the Hunt V1. That's old school Wolf right there. Letting Ted know if he wants a brawl, that's exactly what he's going to get. Single knee backbreaker into a Russian leg sweep. And, of course, vintage CMV security not going to come out here and try to break things up between these two. Look at Josh Wolf mocking the Ted from the ring. Saying you made a mistake here tonight, my friend. Now you're not going to be making it to Point Break either. Trio of elbows to the side of the head. I don't think either one of these guys is going to stop anytime soon. You can see the fire in Ted's eyes. Ooh, nice STO by Wolf. Ted just not able to contain his anger. Can't say that I necessarily blame him, but putting the match at Point Break in further jeopardy here. Look at this. Josh Wolf using his own head to just bash Ted's skull in. Now going after the hand. Where's the rest of Click? Bob Luger and Xander Slate not out here trying to help Wolf, but where's Timotheus? We know Tracy James is not here tonight, but Timotheus, formerly known as Tim LaFave, nowhere to be seen either. And these two just continue to beat the hell out of each other. Slowly bringing Ted up to his feet. German suplexing and launchman in the corner, or at least attempts to do so. Elbow to the jaw by Ted, and a cheeky jab. Knife edge chop. The flinch, though. And now Ted gonna go to work, man. He's been waiting all week to get his hands on a member of Click. Couldn't wait to Point Break. Bending back on that wrist, and you can hear these fans are certainly 100% behind the Ted chanting, break his fingers. It all comes to a head at Point Break, and that anything goes. Tornado tag team matchup, Click versus Timotheus and the team. But I don't know if either of these guys, nor Tracy James, anyone for that matter, gonna show up at 100%. They're just trying to kill each other over these last couple of weeks. The Ted having his way with Josh Wolf here, middle of the ring for everyone to see. He didn't want to do this backstage in some dark corner. He wanted to beat Josh Wolf's ass. Oh, and there's the Ted Buster! You know what comes after that, my friends? Ted. What the hell is this? Ted with a figure four sharpshooter? What a combination this is. Josh Wolf does not want to stick around in this for very long. Able to push Ted off, but you know Wolf is feeling some type of way right now. Able to kick out the knee of Ted, set him up for that vintage DDT. And Wolf's not one to play around. He's got Ted hurting, looking to finish the job. On the Hunt V2, and Josh Wolf left standing tall. The Ted tried to get some payback for his tag team partner, his friend Tracy James, here tonight. let his anger get the better of him and paid for it in the end.
Imagine playing Fortnite in the year of our Lord, 2022. Couldn't be me. But coming up next, lads and gents, our co-main event. Some tag team action in the women's division as the Pure gets set to take on the unbeaten team of Violet Evans and James Stone, who over these last couple weeks, guys, has continuously gotten the better of our women's tag team champions, the Soul Sisters, as did the Pure last week here on Octane, defeating Felicity and Amaya in a non-title matchup. This could be seen as a pseudo number one contenders matchup. Both teams making it clear they want a shot at those women's tag team titles. Of course, still to come in our main event, Ruga, making his debut as he goes toe-to-toe with the global champion, Blake Virtue. Apex is just better in every way. The best Battle Royale. Apex, it's for real men who want a serious challenge, not for little boys. Fortnite in the mud, to be honest. L. Mickey Mouse Battle Royale game. Alright, Gumball, let's play the Xbox 360 version. I'll invite you to the game after the show's over. Let's play the original Xbox version of Counter-Strike. Come on, man, I got it. Let's do a LAN party. Where you at, bro? Good. Crizzy's looking for someone to play with. Brad, it's a bannable offense to say anything negative about Mass Effect. Just warning you. Just a fair warning. That's in the rules. This is what I think about Fortnite. Dot Diamond just playing FIFA year after year. We don't want your opinion. Well, Scott Trisha, Tutorial, and Cinderelle coming off that win against the Soul Sisters last week here on Octane, and it looks as though the Soul Sisters are going to be joining us at ringside for this matchup. I wanted to get a front row seat for what could be considered a number one contenders match. Both the Pure and the team of Violet Evans and Jane Stone have gotten the better of them here in the new season. Soul Sisters desperate to turn things around. No, you know what? I don't want to hear anything from Diamond, because every time I'm on Discord and I go into my DMs and it shows my friends and what they're doing, this man's playing Assassin's Creed. So I don't want to hear anything about video game opinions from Diamond. He's officially out of this conversation. Violet Evans and Jane Stone, no doubt an unusual duo, but they have been very successful over the last couple of weeks, holding a non-title victory against the Soul Sisters, and also Jane Stone knocking off Felicity in singles action. As soon as I see a DM from Diamond, I just hit the little X and close it. I don't need to hear anything an Assassin's Creed fan has to say. So here we go, the Pure taking on Violet Evans and Jane Stone. Both teams wanting a shot at the Soul Sisters for the women's tag team titles. Scott Trisha Tutorial going to start things off here against Evans. Instantly getting met with them knees to the midsection and a basement drop kick and a turn her inside out. Looks like we've got Amaya in one corner and Felicity in the other. No love for either team competing here tonight, but a wise move, I would say, on the part of the women's tag team champions. Letting both teams know they ain't running away. They're here to fight. Whichever gets the shot, Tequila Sunrise locked in by Violet Evans. Escapes it though to Scott Trisha Tutorial, those long, long legs of hers. Speaking of, using them again. Knife edge chop, elbow to the side of the head. Whoa! Did you see that axe kick straight out the cage? My goodness, that was beautiful. And now, Jesus. Trisha trying to rip off Violet's nose. Stop to the upper back. Tag now made to Cinderella. Violet Evans just trying to recuperate from the onslaught brought down upon her by Scott Trisha Tutorial. Comes in from behind, gets an elbow. Irish went now into the corner of Violet Evans. A bit more cautious. She nails Cinderella in the throat with a forearm smash. Kicks to the chest. Using that top rope for some leverage. Gotta be careful though, doesn't get disqualified. Pendulum Meteora. Ooh, strutting her stuff as she walks out of the corner. In comes Jane Stone. I've been very impressed with Jane Stone since the beginning of this new season. Proving herself to be a very deadly submission artist as well, with that knee bar of hers tapped out both Amaya and Felicity with it. Cinderella trying to crawl away after that butterfly suplex. What's wrong with FIFA, bro? I don't know, it's the same game year after year. That's every sport game, though, so. I just said FIFA because he's British. I'm racist like that. Tag made to Violet Evans. Taller, more stronger between she and Jane Stone. Seems like she wants to step up her submission game as well. Tequila Sunrise locked in again. Patricia Toyo going to come in to help out her tag team partner. Since Tutorial down to the outside. Oh, and a DDT gonna jam the neck of Cinderella. Things not looking so good for the Pure. This matchup against the rookies. They want that shot at the women's tag team titles. Hot tag Mina Scott Tutorial just as Violet Evans makes the tag to Jane Stone. Midsection. High kick from Tutorial. Now Jane Stone put in the corner. Turns her around. Forearm smash to the middle of the back. Everything Tutorial does is just so cringe inducing. Her offense. And she's very, very smart using those long legs of hers. Pendulum Meteora that Violet Evans was utilizing earlier. And look at that, mocking Violet Evans. You gotta use what God gave you. Scott Trisha Tutorial does that perfectly. Cinderella brought back in now. Forearm smash. Jane Stone right back down on her derriere. Couple of punches between the eyes. Gonna get Jane Stone free. Working on another butterfly suplex. Now makes the tag to Violet. Kick to the midsection, caught. Oh man, and an enziguri. Great way to counter the counter. Hammerlock, scoop, slam. Violet Evans starting to broaden her horizons here. Beautiful fisherman's driver with a bridge to pin. Be enough to knock off the Pure here. Oh man, it's got Trisha Tutorial with a double axe handle. Just took out Violet Evans. Jane Stone going to make her pay, though. Jane Stone going to make sure to stay on top of her here at ringside. Amaya and Felicity continuing to just watch. Not interfering, not getting involved. Content to see what goes down here between their two rival teams. We see at ringside Jane Stone beating the hell. Oh, and it's got Trisha Tutorial. Boardbuster GTS. One, two, three. Tag team wrestling chant by the fans here in attendance for Octane number three. Oh, Cinderella with a bear hug. Squeezing and squeezing. Surrender out. Oh. Oh, man. Violet Evans gets herself free with a couple of elbows and then clapping the temples of Cinderella. I thought it was over right there. I was going to say, Cinderella, deceivingly powerful, man. She is strong. Maybe one of the stronger competitors in the women's division, as a matter of fact. Violet Evans, though, expertly able to escape. Front wrench suplex now, Cinderella. Walking Violet Evans around the ring, and it ain't no nice day through the park. Violet Evans deciding to go mask off here. Barraging Cinderella with those strikes. Gives her the chance to make the tag to Jane Stone. Oh, bicycle, big boot from Stone. Hooks that leg. And once again, the Pure in trouble. Oh, I don't even think Johnson saw that rope break. So Scott Trisha Tutorial truly saving this matchup for the Pure there. Oh, Violet Evans throwing Scott Trisha down to the outside. She ain't done beating that ass just yet. Big knee to the face. That's in the ring. Jane Stone
with that knee bar. Knee bar locked in. The same knee bar she used to tap out both Amaya and Felicity. Taps out Cinderella here tonight. Another huge win for the team of Violet Evans and Jane Stone. This unlikely duo, man, coming out of nowhere here in the new season and taking no prisoners. I really thought it was over here when Cinderella had that bear hug cinched in on Violet Evans, but able to escape. And here we see the beginning of the end. That bicycle big boot leading into the knee bar. Look at that, the way she has it bent off to the side. Woof! Cinderella lasted longer than I would have. I think most people would have. But in the end, tapping out. Violet Evans and Jane Stone know what they want, and that's a shot at the women's tag team titles. I'd say they've earned it at this point. By the way, y'all talking about Fortnite, but I bet you didn't get your mother some beautiful flowers. You know what I'm saying? Bateman, your mom better have some flowers on the table. Happy Mother's Day. And it is indeed time for our main event here on Octane number 3 as the Hulking Ruga, joined by his cousin, Kwame Bullitt, going to take on the CMV Global Champion, Blake Virtue. What do you think? I'm some piece of shit? Come on now. Got her an air fryer. Uh-oh. Now we're going to have a best son competition. I'm the best son. I don't want to hear anything about it. Thank you for the subscription, Gumble. Gumble got his mom a sheep's pelt. Left that on the kitchen table. No, I'm just kidding. Gumble's mom is a sheep. Went out there this morning. Fed her some carrots, whatever the fuck you feed sheep, I don't know. But indeed, we now know that at Point Break, Kwame Bullitt will challenge Blake Virtue for the CMV Global Championship after winning that six-pack challenge last week here on Octane. Kwame Bullitt, honestly, looking like he's got the advantage going into that championship match. Not only has he been racking up the dubs so far this season, but also Point Break going to be coming to us live from Kwame's home country of Canada, the Great White North. He'll be competing in front of his friends, his family. Blake Virtue going to be desperately trying to turn things around here tonight. Yeah, it's been a rough go for Blake Virtue here in the new season. You'd be the first one to admit it. Last week here on Octane, and I'm sure he's still feeling the effects of that low blow. Hopefully he's got himself a cup here tonight to make sure it doesn't happen again. Richie James Harden, one of the bigger upsets here in the new season so far.
Well, Blake Virtue has undoubtedly got his work cut out for him here. However, this is Ruga's debut match. Very inexperienced. Blake Virtue potentially capitalize on that. I'm sure Kwame Bullitt instructing his cousin to do as much damage here tonight as possible. Make sure that Blake Virtue does not walk into Point Break at 100%. Blake Virtue saying that global championship is not going anywhere, admitting that he suffered a couple of losses so far this season, but when the lights are on bright at Point Break, when that championship is up for grabs, when the dust settles, he will still be the CMV global champion, not letting that title get away from him so quickly after all he did to capture it once again. Blake Virtue was on fire the last couple of months of last season. Maybe it's the pressure, maybe it's the bright lights that have gotten to Blake Virtue these last couple of weeks, but he's got to shake that off now. He's got to focus. Cannot afford this loss here tonight. So here we go, main event time. Ruga making his debut, the cousin, the bodyguard of number one contender, Kwame Bullitt. And we see Virtue comes out swinging. Look at this, Ruga wearing his watch during the match, man. Able to push back Blake Virtue. Ruga obviously going to enjoy this strength advantage, but first we're seeing of what Ruga truly brings to the table. Watching at ringside, hoping that Blake Virtue doesn't necessarily take the loss here tonight, although I'm sure that would be the cherry on top, but more so that Ruga does so much damage. Virtue walks into Point Break barely able to stand. That would be the ideal outcome for Kwame Bullitt here tonight, the former undisputed world heavyweight champion. Of course, only held that title for 5 minutes, potentially less. We all know what happened. Cameron Craig cashing in his Money in the Bank contract on Kwame Bullitt only a couple of minutes after he beat John Lipnick for the Undisputed World Heavyweight Championship really changed Kwame's outlook. Made him a lot more bitter in the subsequent losses to John Lipnick, including at CyberSlam, didn't help. Kwame Bullitt coming into this new season with a whole new attitude and bringing Ruga with him. Won that six-pack challenge last week, and now he's got his shot, his chance to once again hold world championship gold. Oh, big boot from Ruga. Blake Virtue tries to get right back up, only to be put back down though with authority. Forearm smash. We see Ruga doing exactly as he is instructed, trying to break apart the body of Blake Virtue. And these fans certainly not on Blake Virtue's side. They want to see his fingers broken. They want to see a whole lot more broken, I'm sure. Well, I mean, your cousin is Kwame Bull, and I'm sure over the past week, Kwame has been training Ruga as much as he can on how to inflict as much pain and agony as humanly possible. Holy shit! Virtue almost took off Johnson's head. He fucking flew. That man almost went to space. Ruga with some brutal gut shots here on the CMV Global Champion. And now knees, knees, knees.
finish it off with yet another big boot, knocking Blake Virtue down to the outside. Throws him back into the ring, though. Doesn't want to risk Virtue getting away with a count out. Although Virtue not the type to do that anyhow. Man, Ruga is just... Oh, spear! Spear off the forearm smash barrage! Two! Holy shit! Virtue cannot catch a break, man. You can't help but to feel for the CMV Global Champion. What's running through his mind? Well, I'm sure not a whole lot right now after that spear. Look at this big motherfucker move! Knee across the head! Virtue just trying to get back into the match, but Ruga decimating the Global Champion. It would be unwise, though, to ever count out Blake Virtue. Look at that knee to the midsection, bro. Seemed like it hurt Virtue more than it hurt Ruga. Come on, Virtue. Great combo to get himself the upper hand. Only lasts about a second, though. Breaks free. Has himself a chance, backing Ruga into the corner. Beautiful disaster kick. Ruga just got his bell thoroughly rung. And here comes another knee to the face. Hooks the leg. Will that be it? One, two, no. So close. Virtue with his hands on his head. But he's not going to stop there. He's got something else in his back pocket. Setting up for the shiniest wizard, maybe. Oh, another spear! Hooks the leg. One, two. Oh, my God. Virtue kicks out of another spear. Unbelievable. Superman punch avoided by Virtue. And here comes the shiniest wizard. Connects. On the money, one, two, three, Blake Virtue needed to win this match, and did, but man, oh man, did Ruga give him the beating of a lifetime. An excellent matchup here in our main event. I'm very impressed with the performance of Ruga, but Virtue, like I said, knew he needed to win this match. Nothing was going to stop him from doing so. Avoiding that Superman punch, hits the shiniest wizard. Lights out dub for Blake Virtue. Ready for Kwame Bullitt at Point Break. Is Kwame Bullitt ready for Blake Virtue?